General updates. Here we go, boys. Here we go. Each player now has their own curry automatically. Feel free to be triggered. My skill cap. Friends, feel free to get out. Curry is now gaining levels when your hero gains levels. What? Curry movement speed reduced from 380 to 275. Curry health reduced. 75. Curry now provides 85 GPM while it is alive. This replaces the base 91 GPM that previously existed. So if it dies, you lose it. Curry passively gains 10 movement speed and 10 health and 2 GPM per level. Oh my god. At level 5. Okay, so when you hit 5, you get flying. Curry gains speed burst active ability at level 10. Six-second duration, 50 moves. Oh, the old speed burst! I remember. Curry gained ability to use wards at level 15. What the fuck? So now, of course, I have to put wards? Curry gains shield activability 20. Okay, which means that Curry will die a lot more now. Because you don't get it until 20. Curry gains ability to use items in general at level 25. Hyper late game Dagon attack. We lol now. How is this a lol in any way? Curry vision reduced. Yeah, so you cannot scout with it that well. Curry team bound is now 25 plus 5 times level. Yes. So if you're level 10, you get 75. If you get level 10 curry, you get 75 gold. Curry respawn time change from 2 to 50 plus 7 times level. Profit sniping? Curry return items ability will now cause a curry to return home even if it doesn't have items. Economy? Observers no longer cost gold? Weird champ.
For sale! Cash up front! Care wards win wars, you know. This way, Mortimer.
Prepare for battle!
So triggered. Here's now start with 3 town portal scrolls. Wow. Very easy now. Gold earned from killing an observer ward will now always be given to the player that bought the true site. Core players, Sebaid? No longer can steal it? Heroes that have recently applied damage or debuff on an enemy hero that dies are not considered part of the area's Cisco, even if they are no longer alive or in that area. Yes. So if you die, you're fine. Assist gold distribution multiplier for network ranking factor in the area to change from multiplying based on heroes in the area to globally. Obviously, finally. Net worth ranking factor for gold change. For gold change from. Yes, okay. Yeah. Map led redesign. No, both ancient camps are now on the opposite side of the map from Roshan. Hold up.
Honor ain't magic, it's art.
Enable cheats.
This is going to be fun.
New map.
I'll pick.
Let me just ban little first. Mods, weird champ. You don't know the rules? Skip ahead, please. Let's see the new map.
Looks like we're just in time, Mortimer.
What? Where am I? What the fuck?
Prepare for battle.
What the hell? Where am I? Okay, so this is roughly the same. Yes. I still have the shrines. New ward spot. New ward. Oh, that's the old one. Yes. This is a new opening here. What? What the fuck?
Zona 3? Pog.
It hurts. Is this ancients?
30 seconds to battle.
On the move.
How about base? Is base the same? Yes. Alright, it changed the jungle a bit. Very cool. Here's gonna level up to 30. Once you get 30, unlock the entire talent tree. XP requirements for levels are 3,000, blah, 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 blah. Respawn time does not increase past 25. XP bounties max out at level 25 bounty values.
Who's making
spelling
that means
you no longer gain 100% magic resistance.
Don't make me pull out my piece.
This means that all spells that are able to pierce spell immunity now deal damage as well. Note 1. A quick refresher on how it is currently working. Spells have two probability. Okay, so spells like what? Doom? Wait, what? Doom was pure. What is a spell? Necro-ult? Necro-ult? Oh my god, that's broken now. Necrophos. Remote side shops. Pepe ants. Wait, what the hell is this? An outpost?
I'll mosey on over.
Oh.
On the prod. Bounty killing.
What the hell is this outpost?
Get along.
Oh, they remarked the bounty runes. Alright, they're all here now.
Let's have a look-see.
All secret shop items are now excusing the secret shop. This means Ring of Health and Voice Stone are longer in the base.
3 years now and you won't even kiss me on the lips.
Ball has been removed from secret shop. Tier 2 towers, HP increased. Tier 2 armor increased. Tier 2 damage. Tier 2 plus towers, night vision increased. Tower glimmer is from 2
whole,
to 4.
Mortimer.
So you hit 5 targets now. Wow. Glyph duration even increased by 1 second. Wow, that's a big deal. Why are these stronger? Alright. Improved input processor to feel snapper as well as fixing some rare input drop bugs. Nice. The Night Towers now give half of the bounty to the team that denies it. And half to the other team. Oh. So actually, siege damage against heroes increased from 85 to 100. Siege damage. There's no way you can find out what is siege damage in Dota. Literally have to wiki it. Fountain now has 20% accuracy. Hog, no more fountain camping. Neutral units balance. Neutral cloaker are no longer stacks. Shen? Sebade? Neutral Hoppy Storm by mana reduced. Okay, the one is you spam the Chain Lightning. Mana regeneration increase, however. Mud Golem damage reduced by a lot. Ghosts buff by 5%. Wool now applies a 35 region reduction. War Stomp. Less cooldown, snare better, raise dead better. Ancient Thunder War Drums no longer provides attack bonus. Now provides accuracy. Increase attack speed, ogre nerfed.
Aid to perfection.
Slow increase, alright. Outpost! Add a new neutral building type. Outpost. These are two of these on the map, located on the where the sideshow were previously. Right clicking to channel it takes 6 seconds, then you gain control of the pout pose.
Take the back way.
Yeah, I cannot.
He'll find his way.
Right clicking to channel it takes 6 seconds, and then you gain control over the outputs. Converts faster with more Alice channeling. Having control over an output grants you bonus experience by initially capturing it, and it had a 5-minute interval on the game clock. It also provides your team unfair vision in that area and allows you to TP to it. Outputs are inactive for the first 10 minutes of the game and cannot be captured then. Okay, so if you hold it, it grants you bonus experience globally? Upon initially capturing it, and at 5-minute intervals on the game clock, it also provides your team provides 500, yes, XP bonuses 25 times min exp, okay, only against experience bonus once prepared, regardless if you have a 1 or 2. Okay, I don't understand anything. Takes 6 seconds to teleport to it. Alright, very cool. Neutral items. Neutral does not drop unique items that cannot be sold but can be shared with allies. Oh no. What? There are 5 tiers of items that are dropped over the course of the game. Within each tier, the odds get cut by half for each of the drop. Items of a specific type drops only begin after 5 minutes of the game. There are 62 unique neutral items in total. Okay, backpack increased. Neutral drop mechanics. 5 to 50 minutes, tier 1, 10% chance. Other 0. Okay, then it increases. At 70 plus minutes, you get tier 5 items.
Trigger fingers itching.
Why does it even say other tier 0%? Okay, just to clarify, I guess. Okay. These are the odds for each. Each is gonna drop between its cut. Okay, so you get items. Tier 1 items. Keen Optic, 75 cast range, 1.5 mana region. Okay. Poor Man's Shield. Boggies. Consumable that comes with 2 charges. Permanently grants 2.5 health region and mana region. It does not stack on the same unit. Sharing is caring. Permanent region. Unkillable build. Ocean Heart grants 4 to all stats. Additionally, provides 10 HP region and 5 mana region while in water. So I guess cores get these and then they give them to the supports and they don't have room. Iron Talon. Poggies. Mango. Consumes plants. Consumable that plants a mango tree. Provides unlimited mango power. Every 60 seconds, a mango will drop. Provides 800 vision around it. Arcane Ring. 8 in 3 armor activators for 70 mana, 75 mana. Alright, Alex. Elixir. Restores 500 health, 250 mana for 6 seconds. Cool. Melee attack range. Wow, Ironwood Tree. Recipe can be used combined with 3 Ironwood branches to create an Ironwood Tree. Provides 7 to all stats and the ability to plant a special tree. Oh. Trusty Shovel, 150 health. Activate to dig with a 1-second channel. Can find a bound rune, a flask, a 2-charge TP scroll bundle, or an enemy kobold. The same roll doesn't appear back-to-back. Cool on 70 seconds. I say if you're lucky, you get bound rune, flask, bound rune, flask, bound rune. So every other you can get a bound rune. What the fuck? Faded Brooch, okay, yes. Grove Bow, 100 attack range. Adds 12 minutes attack buff on attack. All right, so like Necrophones, I guess, or something like that. Mirana, Viper Fang, Lifesteal, Spell Lifesteal, Night Vision. Aquila is back. Repair Kit. Three charges. Consumable that targets a building. Restores 40% of its health over 30 seconds. Provides 10 armor and 4 multi-shot during this period. Oh my god. Oh my god. Wait, so it doesn't break on damage?
You can just some shine on it.
Use this when they're pushing? So you use Glyph and this, the tower hits a gazillion. Pupil's Gift grants you 14 attributes for both of your secondary stats. Oh, interesting. So not for the main set you probably want, except for some heroes. Like Prophet would love this, he doesn't really care about Int. Helm of the Undying provides 6 armor. Equipped hero survives an extra 5 seconds after receiving a killing blow. Underlords!
Your middle tower is under attack.
Oh, that's insane. So you give the support after you don't have room on core, and it's Maiden who can just continuously ult. Or oh my god. There's so many areas you want to burst, and you just give it to the support, and it will get all spells off. Well, this item is broken. I can tell you right now, this item is insanely good. Imp Claw, passive, 18 plus damage. Cause your next attack to deal 1.6x damage. Pog. Philosopher's Stone, 75 GPM! Minus 65 attack damage on yourself. Or what? So you do less damage. Or do you take more damage? That's pretty sweet. Support will love that. Dragon Scale. Dragon Scale! 5 armor, 5 HP regen. Your attacks now has an afterburner, deals 12 damage per second. For 3 seconds. Effects building. Siege item. So if you attack it once, you do 36 damage. Nice. Dragon Knight. Essence Ring. 6 in 2.5 mana region.
Many friends.
Activate and increase your max HP by 375 for 15 seconds. Heals you. Costs 200 mana. Okay. A heal. It's 25 second cooldown. 8 spell M, 20 magic
season,
minus 4
armor. When are you streaming with Cyclops again?
I don't know. I don't know if he plays Dota anymore. Consumable that probably grants you accepted, but for 3 minutes? Lycan. Yes, Lycan. Tier 3 items. Here we go. 13 armor, but you do have less attack speed. Unkillable build. Nice. Greater Fairy Fire. 2 charges, 30 damage, consumes the instant restore 500 elf. Well, that's really good.
Your middle tower is
cooldown reduction,
attack.
HP region. Oh. Cooldown reduction. Oh, that's so good. That's mana break and 50 magic resistance. Mana burn this way is given to you. Mana burn this way is given to you. Oh, so you get the mana. Illusions deal 6. Plus mana break. Why isn't it called mana steal then?
Always did it the right way.
Third my eye grants true sight in a 500 radius and 300 plus day and night vision. Has 3 charges. If 3 deaths, it disappears. Free gem? Oh, wow. Spider Legs dance game. Provides 24% movement speed. Doesn't stack with boots. What? And plus 30 turnate. That's pretty relevant as far as I know. Can be activated to gain free pathing.
Mother comes!
And 24 plus moves for 3 seconds. Destroy trees along the way. Free path? Wait, do you mean over cliffs? Wait, over a 10 second cooldown? Oh my god, 10 second how do you catch them? Oh my god, that's so annoying. This will be an annoying one. Test it, how do I test it? Vam Brace. Recipe combines two braces, two rage bands, two nulls to create a corresponding strength, agility, or... so it's a recipe, so you need to buy these items, which is 3,000 gold. Wait, yes, 3,000. Item, spider legs.
Josie Papians.
Oh, it worked.
Should we hurry? This ain't no hayride.
10-second cooldown. Oh no, I'm being ganked, guys.
I'll enjoy the ride.
How do you catch the ports? Oh, I'm scouting. Oh, they're coming. I just run away then, guys. Don't mind me.
Unlimited power! Unlimited power, you fuck!
Okay, so this guy's 14 designated attribute, 8 all other attributes, 12 magic resistance, 8. Item. Let's do that. Item.
Gem of true sight. Giddy up!
Okay, so I can choose?
Your middle tower is under attack!
Don't need roads!
How do you give me strength? I want to choose!
Mortimer will get us there.
Is this good? Oh, you see, you don't need to buy it. Alright, it's for free, alright. Yeah, it's pretty nice, I guess. Climbs in at 5, also at 3, minor attack. Activate to ensnare yourself and to target the enemy for 2 seconds. God damn it!
Sure!
It doesn't work through magic.
Run and
gun! Range? Oh my god, a range!
Look at his waddle!
Passive cooldown. Your next range attack has 400 range and does 175 damage and has true strike.
Sure as a gun.
Axe likes you. Axe will kill you last.
This way, Mortimer.
Oh my god. That's pretty sweet. That's pretty sweet. Paladin sword, 70 damage, 70 lifesteal, 70% healing, regen, and lifesteal amp. Overstruction, attacks apply a debuff that reduce armor by 6. Slow for 30, 50 for melee range holders for 4 seconds.
Hey, Monica, hey,
Titan sliver, 22 base damage, Terror Blade. Gets like a gazillion from this. Magic resistance, stage resistance. Aw, stage resistance. Oh my god, this is so insane. Tier 4. Grants them max health and minus max mana. Pretty sweet. Debuff duration, amplification, and spell lamp. Oh, debuff. Oh my god, this on Rubik. His stun will be like 10 seconds long. This one here is insane on some heroes, I'm sure. Bane? Oh my god, Bane will get million seconds. Actually, let's try it. Let's try it on Bane.
You're looking for cooking tips, violence, Bane? Or
Bane? Bane of your existence.
Okay, so we have the talent now as well.
Evil dreams await.
Enemy, level enemy to max. I ult him right now. It's... Wait, why is it even more? Why does it auto-cast it? They must have changed something. Oh, it's a passive now. Oh, so this is passive. This is 17 seconds. Only 23 seconds.
for 9,000!
The tide of night advances.
Spell Brism. All right, let's move on. 8 all stats can be activated to cause your next single target non-ultimate ability or item to be duplicated on a different nearby enemy hero. Hero priority. As your next single target. So, Ogre Stun can now be cast on 2. PA Dagger. Cool on 80. Well, who's this good on? Doom. Guys, this has non-ultimate. Non-ultimate ability. I'm not sure if you're reading that. Ability or item. Oh my god, Midas. Double Midas? Double X? Lion. Non-ultimate. Oh, 60% attack projectile speed. Your next attack exits the enemy hero into frog for 5. What?
Hey, good.
Axe is not axe.
Am I gonna project that?
I'll own your soul.
Okay, projection being faster. Is that good? I mean, the hex is insane, obviously.
Why are we still here? Just to suffer.
Activate the spell debuff and blink. Activate to dispel debuffs and blink in a random direction 600 range away. Cooldown 5 seconds. Flash! Does not get disabled on incoming damage. Oh no. Flicker.
Sleep no more.
This is random direction. Oh! If you're lucky, you just go into a corner and boom. Oh, I didn't get lucky. Maybe I get lucky now. Nope. Maybe I get lucky now. Oh, on the other side, guys.
Signs
it's
going to
be very nice for support. Telescope. Lowers scan cooldown by 50%. Increases attack and cast range of an enemy by 125. Support. We'll love it. Ninja gear, 20 gil, 25 minutes. Activate the cast smoker seat on your yourself.
Ow!
Basically, you're gonna keep this in your backpack now because you got 4.
Agreed.
Illusionist cape, increase illusion damage by 10%. Can be activated to create an illusion of you that deals 50% and takes 150 for 2 seconds. Oh my god! Oh my god! Illusions. 30-second cooldown. Avic Hammer. Increase bat by 0.3. Came back to the knock enemies down with 300 AoE. Back by a distance of 250. Okay.
Wait till they get a load of me.
They nerfed him.
I fail.
Oh, no. Oh, they removed the bat.
You're the boss.
Attack speed 14. It's not even increasing.
Is it?
Attack!
Oh, wait, it's a penalty. Wait, what? Am I pegged? Increase it bad. Okay. Uh-huh. Alright, Magic Lamp has it 400 health. Hardest spells and heals you for 300 when you drop below 15% health. Wow. The Leveler. 50 your attacks, cleave, and splash for 50%. Wow. Minotaur Horn. 20 strength. Activate to gain magic immunity for 1.575 seconds. Tier 5 items. Only 70 minutes, boys. It's So this will almost never happen. But if the game goes long enough, we're probably going to get some broken items. Force boots. Okay, so just force boots. 50% movement speed. Wait, how much is boots? That's pretty high, isn't it? Travel is 32. 50% movement speed.
Pour it on!
So with normal boots, I would have 360. Force boots. Oh, wow. That is a lot of movement speed, man. Is that longer? Oh, that's way longer. Where did it change this? 600.
Hey! Whoa! Spill.
Whoa! Help!
Go, go, go!
No sound effect.
Little bit of this.
Actually, no sound effect.
Whatever you say.
Okay, so that 50% movement is insanely good.
Hey, Henry.
500 cast range. Plus 800 day and night vision ketchup. Vision, insanely good. Insanely good. You put it in a support. All of a sudden your maiden can cast spells and without dying. The vision you gain from this. On bat. Oh no.
Yeah, I'm sorry.
This on bat.
Right into battle. You don't ride at all.
The same movement or missions, it is. It is. And you get the force boots. Where are my force boots?
One force.
And you find someone, you grab them.
I got something to show you. Hell yeah! Time for some rope work.
This item is very good on bat. Mirror shield, 75 chance to block and reflect targeted spells. Oh my god. Is that good? No. It sounds good, but is that good? If an enemy has it, you just don't cast single target on it. And will at 70 minutes, your cores are not going to want to have this item. Will they? Actually, it's not that bad. 20 stats. It's not that good. Your supports will have it. Pretty nice. Fallen Sky. Recipe combines Blink Dagger, Meteor Hammer. Gains 20 strength. Fallen. Okay. Blink Stun. Nothing wrong here. Uh-huh. 15 gives a lot of stats. Actors. Gas range 1600. Does not get disabled by incoming death. Oh my god, you can blink whenever you want. Old blink. I have a little cheat here, though. Oh my god, that is good. You take damage, just blink away. Let's tag with blink. Well, yes, it should.
Now I can burn it both ends.
It is plus 70 minute game though, which will not happen a lot. Fusion rune. This item are just to end the game. This is too much. This is plus 70. This, you will never get these items, guys. These items are for in case of stalemates. In case the game goes 70 plus minutes, these items will end the game. Tier 4 and 3 and 2 and 1 items are way weaker. Consumable that can be activated and gain every power in for 50 seconds.
What a ride! Look out!
Oh my, this on Terrorblade, that's what I'm
keeping
thinking.
My knees in the breeze.
Haste, very good on Terrorblade because he's pretty slow. Arcurine, insanely good. Invis, pretty useless. DD, insanely good.
Go.
Illusion, insanely good.
It's not time yet.
Increase your primary attribute by 80%.
Swoop in.
What this a on ride. A Guild of the Heroes. This on a Guild of the Heroes. On Strength Heroes.
Better living through alchemy.
I think Centaur. No Centaur. Here's the highest strength gain, I believe.
No!
Well, oh, I cash all 3,000 life. Flush. Nothing wrong here.
A dull blade, but heavy.
Ballista, 400 attack range. Attacks knock enemy 15 distance back. Poggies, steel it's time spread. For sniper.
A dying bot.
Okay, so we already have these.
I have many friends. Many
Ballista.
Friends.
To the enemy!
On target.
Cut and run! To battle! Take
attack!
My blade.
Help! I cannot
into
move!
Wars,
blood has been spilled for
this one
through
seems
the
very.
Him off.
You cannot move. You cannot move.
Full bore.
You cannot move. Okay, this one seems a little bit bonkers. Woodland Striders, 50% movement speed. Unlocks max movement speed and grants 50 health regen. Grants tree walking. Accurate to leave trees in the warrior wake as you're moving. Woodland. Okay, so it gives a lot of movement speed. First of all, it gives you 140 movement speed. That is very interesting. Yeah, I have Sunshine Asha as well. Unlocks max movement speed.
My spotter guides me. Line of sight.
What? Bro, you can't run through it.
My spotter.
Wait, how long do they last? Tree life is 1 minute. Can they walk past it? No.
You want power? That's power, son.
No trajectory.
This is good though. 50 health region is pretty good.
Spotted.
This on
Do
a
you
tank.
Think the RNG from these creep items will ruin the game of heroes. Get the perfect item and snowball.
No, because the early items are very unimpactful. Again, the items after 70 minutes are broken because they want to end stalemates. They're supposed to end stalemates. Early items will not be as good. Trident! Resurrection Sun, Jash, and Kaya! Oh, 33% mana loss reduction. Tinker. 30 spell amps. Status is. Oh. Book of the Dead. Activate summon 6 level 3 Necronomicons for 90 seconds. Wow, this one seems the worst one by far so far. Book of. Book of the Dead. Bruh. Give me the book.
Yes.
Well, I mean, it's just 6 necros. They will just die. That seems not so good. It's good on profit for adding, I guess. It's called Demonomicon. Demon. Oh. Uh-huh. Keep in mind you get this at 70 minutes, which means that enemy cores will kill them in 1 second. Enemy cores will kill them in 1 second.
Yeah.
When is this practical, except Lycan maybe for ratting and profit ratting?
Of course.
Very short cooldown, or downtime, I guess. Also, at this point, giving away gold to enemy cores is not that relevant, because it will most likely have all the items they want anyway.
So
it's not a big deal that you feed them. It's a big deal if you feed necros early, but not at this point. Good for Rat, I guess. Very nice for profit. Grants 250 attack speed. When you kill an enemy hero, a bounty rune spawns between you and the target. 250 attack speed.
Yes.
But how much does the rune? 240?
As you say.
Okay, so realistically, I mean, I have these items, but my attack speed is 040.
Yeah.
040, I add this. 030, nice. Pirate.
025. Into the
breach. As you say. Whoa, killing spree! Oh!
He's dominating!
At 70 minutes, if you do get a kill, your supports will smiley face at you. Your supports will very, very much smiley face at you. Ex Machina, 25 armor. Activate to refresh all item cooldowns. Except refresh orb. Activate to refresh all item cooldowns. How good is that? 30 second, wait, 30 second cooldown? I thought it was like a refresher. Again, the main problem is item slots. If you had infinite item slots, this will be one of the most broken items. But if you're playing late game AM, you don't have room for this. But you can do double X, like maybe Invoker? Desolator 2, 100 attack, 12 armor. Yes, you can do the one-shot combos. E-Blade Dagon, E-Blade Dagon, they die, I guess. Phoenix Ash. 30 to all stats. Lethal damage is burned and heals you to full HP. You can see when I'm triggering, one charge gets right after use. I like your hook. How many items can you find of these? That's what I don't understand.
Alright,
so these are super broken. Let me just do a quick... Yeah, that one's... Let's just see the tier. This one is insanely good. Yeah, it's insanely good. Insanely good. Maybe good. Insanely good. Potentially great. Potentially great. Insanely good.
Goblin.
Seems insane. I think it's like bristle with this. Seems insanely good. Insanely good. Question mark.
Shout out to
question
my boy,
mark. This one seems pretty bad as long as this one. Unless it's the right game, like Prophet or Lycan. 250 attack speed. It's nice, I guess. Yes, yes. Item changes. Removed stock shield from the game! Oh, no, melee heroes now have a passive 8 damage block.
Many friends. Many
stacks
friends.
With other sources of damage block. I'm sure you considered Lone Druid when you did this change, Ice Frog, so you didn't like make the bear have zero armor or block now. Because that would be very sad.
Oh!
It'd be very sad if Lone Druid has no defense.
Because
it says melee heroes. Let me get, he forgot about it. He forgot about Lone Druid, and now the bear dies like a little bitch early. That's what's gonna happen.
Insert hero here.
We'll see, we'll see. Remove Sasha from the game. Wait, what did Sasha, didn't he do 20 damage block? Because now you block 8 damage every attack. Now requires a 200 gold recipe. So if you hit my maiden now, she just does nothing.
I have many
Crawling
friends.
Blade cost reduced, melee damage reduced, range bonus reduced. So this one is... Does this matter? This is a buff to Tiny because he can now out deny enemy heroes easier. Orb of Venom nerfed. Okay. Cost, yes. Then all these are buffed. Okay, and cost.
Don't tell
here.
Him, chat, Pepe laugh.
Cost increased. Okay. 50 more gold. Oh my god. How is this a value? 50 more gold for 15. Oh, this is useless now. Mangos, they cannot be stacked. Oh, the max region. Well, fairy, no one's buying fairy fire anymore. That's fucking trash. Ring of protection value. Sage mask. Whoa, hold up. Ring of protection lane will be very good now. Force staff increased because of the ring of region. Nothing big. Let's be increased because of this. Now requires one ring of protection, one iron bench, and 250 gold recipe. No longer has an active castable buff.
Are you seeing that? I'd look out if I was you.
Another card of Sage Mask, one Iron Breath, but everyone's buying Iron Breath, so this is very nice.
No, your middle tower! Are you seeing that?
Okay, so this doesn't have armor anymore. Address, the same. Provides 3 tall stats. 2 health region aura. Vladimir old, yes, we all know the old one. New, Ring of Vasilius, like before, but a little bit changed. Morbid Mask, yes, Buckler. Instead of recipe. See, it's more expensive now. 6 doll stats. Gave nothing before. 3 Armara versus 4. Same region. Lifesteal aura, 25 for all, I assume. It doesn't say, so I assume it's for all. Let's just test it. Lads.
Of course.
Enemy hit me.
Spotted.
Yes. Okay. Way more lifesteal now. Way more. Range get 15% more. Lose the attack damage though. That is true. That hurts quite a bit. 6 all stats, pretty valuable. Dominate now, aura bonus are now 15 strong on player units. Dominate aura. Can you shut the fuck up here? Headdress. Broadsword crown. Price is more expensive. 7 to all stats. Base damage aura. Okay, so if you want damage or not for your Terror Blade, you buy this as support, I guess? What does it mean? Dominated aura bonus are now 15 strong on player units. For your entire team. Very cool. Alright, stop spamming, guys, so I'm gonna have to start banning you. I'm gonna start banning people now.
Why, come on, your middle tower is under attack!
Stop spamming. Drums. Ground, wind lace, glove of haste, recipe. Movement speed, attack speed, aura. Now uses chainmail instead of buckler. Provides 6 armor for all stats. No armor, aura, inactive. Health region reduced. Crimson, helm iron wheel instead of buckler. Did buckler get removed?
Let's look at.
No, it's not removed. Fucking asshole. Now provides 6 armor, no base armor aura. Still has the threshold armor region aura. Recipe cost reduced from 1800 to 1600. Okay. Where's my music?
The funk.
Marcus Buckner and so Shane Mail gains plus five stats.
Many friends.
Nice. That performs a blink strike, has 600 range. Oh my god, Bash now deals damage from spell immunity.
No, your middle tower! Are you seeing that? Your middle tower is fallen!
Oh my god, that's so much better. Didn't this have melee before? It was melee. So now in PA, she just like kills you. Oh my god, it's so much better for a lot of melees. Lifestealer, PA. This is a big buff, and it also deals damage now. Awesome, now combines Kaya and Soul Booster instead of Mystic Staff. Oh my god, Storm buff provides a bonus, the base bonus from both, plus 200 regen. Each charge now gains 0.2 million and 0.35 spell amp. Well, hold up, so if you got 20 charges, you get 7 spell amp. Not that much, but it's nice, I guess. Alright, this makes Sven a lot better as well, because he's always being kited. But with an Abyssal, he cannot be kited, but he doesn't really want Abyssal, though. That's very nice. So now provides 24 herself, HP region, life amp instead of 8 damage. Stage is buffed! Wait, what did it do? Self HP region. Yes, and life steal amp. I'm gonna assume Kaya doesn't work with Bloodstone. Test it.
Bloodstone.
Oh, it doesn't stack.
Forward.
What is the question? Okay, don't refresh. Wait, how do I heal then? Let me just see how broken this can be.
We are like, whoa, what I missed?
So if you're lucky and get this, you would now do... It's not even that much. It doesn't even do the maths for you. Nah, it's not that broken. 600 damage, Shadow Gremlin.
He's super godlike.
Alright. So Sanchka buffed quite a lot, honestly. 4% more Sages is very good, and 8 damage is irrelevant. So now you get more health regen and lifesteal amp, which most cores will have lifesteal. Very cool, and then this one is even more. When you go Sanchiasha, 12 damage, no one will care really. 4 more, so very nice. Halberd the same. How much is that really? I mean, you get like 10 more region maybe?
Smile chat.
6 more resistance, very nice. Same here, obviously. Holy Locket! No longer provides regeneration amplification. Heal amplification increases from 25 to 35. Heal, health increased by 50, now requires magic wand! Instead of cloak, there we go, boys. There we go, everyone will buy this item now. Everyone wants wand all game. Wait, how bad is it, bro? Wand is one of the most valued items in the entire game, but it takes item slots. But now, oh lord, it's kind of expensive. That is very expensive. Maybe it's not that good. Amplify heals you provide. So if you have 17 charges... heal for a lot. I can't do the math, but it's a lot. It's like 400? 400 heal?
Yeah.
3 toss stats. It's kind of expensive, though.
Gambling on.
I don't know. Maybe it's not that good. It's way too expensive. Probably just buy it on Necro, Dazzle. Even a Dazzle, not really. Wow, 100 less. Enchantress. This could be good on Enchantress. Attack speed increased. Midas. Recipe cost increased by... Oh my god. Well, now the item is dead. Now this item is so fucking trash. If Gorp still buys this...
With skipping grace.
I mean, you still buy it on the hero that really need it, like Lifestealer, I guess. Wraith King. Wraith King, Lifestealer. 100 more. Dude, this used to cost... 1,400 gold.
My daughter!
450 more gold.
Alright,
I'm retarded. It's the same price, actually. It's the same price, never mind. Attack speed increase for 5 minutes. Recipe cost increased? What? As it's a new patch. Alright, it's because of a thing, you're right. Because of the gloves again. Increase your paganism. Narcos ring of seals and so recipe cost increased. Now I'm fighting my spell damage by 20% of reducing magic resistance. Affects pure damage as a result. Well, that's a lot better, isn't it? Or is it? OD? Who does a lot of pure damage? Who does a lot of pure damage burst?
This
one's I'm sure they reworked it. Fortress afloat in the dark. Yeah, they reworked it, guys. Look at this. I told you. They reworked it. I knew they were going to rework this. Bad news. Base damage 300. Mana difference. Wait, mana difference? Of shadows, now requires Sage's Mask instead of refuse raindrops. One more count. Wait, it doesn't build into anything then, does it?
Darkness advances.
No. One more tick. No, that's yes. Pretty valuable. Yes. Lina. Yes. This will do 20% more damage with Lina X now. That is very accurate. Instead of 1,000, it'll do 200 more. That provides 10 health regen. Nice. Duration, nerf, cooldown. Alright, that's overall a buff. Wait, this is actually very good on Void now. It was bad on Void, or kinda good on Void, but because it was 8 seconds, you kinda fuck you in the ass sometimes. But now it's good on Void. Now people would go my Void build. Mask of Madness, Shadowblade build. That was my Void build. Now comes in a single charge for 90 gold. Duration increase from 6 to 8 minutes. Well, have fun in this heroes. Riki fan straights. This, wait, wasn't this like 3 minutes back in the old days? What was it? 8 minutes. Blocking camps. RIP 2k Dota, cannot deward them. Initial stock reduced. So, I mean, they replenish less, but. Whenever I play with Mega Cards, there's always 10 in bank. Like, every game, this says 10 here, so they never buy it. Initial stock reduced from 3 to 2. Stock replenish cooldown reduced from 10 to 7. More smoke ganks. More action. This is a pretty big change. No longer pierce Spell immunity. Armor increased by one. Wait, what does that mean? So if you have BKB, you don't do damage back now. Are you typing F? I'm not lagging, am I? Item. Bash now deals through magic immunity. Okay, that's a small change, but nice. No longer bounce the primary target if it is spell immune. It still bounces, right?
From the world on the rim. I herald your destruction.
Okay, that's nice. BKB buff, no longer pierces spell immunity. Now deals damage to spell immunity as a result of spell immunity change. But this one doesn't. What? Okay. Damage increased by 5. Slark is back. Damage increase 9. Oh, from 5 plus to 6! 6! Damage increased by 3! Holy shit! Cooldown reduced 12. All stats increased. Minor buffs to Lincoln.
Free
it deserves
rewards,
it.
Personal careers. There is no more gap between
good.
2k and 8k Bog Chomp.
Free wards? Boggies? Select one contains a 24 collision blocker at the base. What? Is it because they watch my stream? Is that it? Oh my god, I cannot go on top of them anymore. Let me restart this one. And you can block now as well.
Prepare for battle.
My reach is low. Use them. You cannot go past them anymore either. Okay, so let's try it then. Level enemy to max. So I do the combo. I'm an expert at. Okay, I mean this, I don't know how big nerf that is. It seems like a pretty big nerf to Asif. You cannot be under them anymore. No longer able to disassemble. Okay, I'm not sure why you'll be able to do that. Didn't even know that. You cannot change Manta anymore. But did you ever do that though? Manta into Sanchiasha Lincoln? Cannot be used on couriers and units. Okay. Hero changes! Self damage is no longer lethal, he can't kill himself! Pepper ants! Curse of Avernus, curse slow reduced by a lot early. Half early. Well, this kills the hero. Like, the playability, not actually kills the hero. This is like, what's the best thing about him, killing himself. Huge nerf. Huge nerf, and this as well. Sometimes in this guy in lane just bullied you so hard. Oh my god, they didn't even nerf Alchemist. Oh my god. Why? Chemical Rage reading to 50. That's a buff. And then the one you always picked, Rage base attack, is now movement speed, which is both pretty bad. Both are pretty bad. However, the game doesn't go that late with Alchemist. The game is decided in the first 20 minutes. That's weird. That is weird. Ice Blood now deals damage through spell immunity. As a result, the spell immunity changed. Yes, Scepter has been reworked. Chilling Touch has no cooldown. Okay, I've been saying this. This hero's axe is useless because they've been buffing it so much. The normal one. The axe on this hero is so bad.
10 months through.
But now, Chilling Touch has no cooldown. What? You can play him as a core? Core AA is back! Ronnie Coleman will have his revenge! Nice, this is what acts are supposed to be. They're not really supposed to be super competitive, and they're supposed to add new ways of playing the hero. Now you can play it as a core. Very cool. Anti-mage changes. This hero needs some love, even though this hero is very annoying, but needs some love.
Ronnie Coleman, here I come!
Now, all mana break. Now also burns 5% of the target's max mana. Okay. That seems pretty good. So, and the illusions is half, so you do per salve 10%. Because you have two illusions with Manta. That seems very good. That seems insanely good.
The Age of Ice begins.
Wait.
Cold, I bring an end to magic.
And here this item, bam, boom.
A blessing.
The path is clear. Spawn of sorcery.
What if targets maximum? So any Leshrac and Odie, you will just burn all their mana?
Onward.
And they will be crying? Second enemy hero. Outworld.
Daddy, will Lundrum get a buff?
I go.
We'll see. Select. Enemy. Level enemy to max. Usually we'll just give him some items.
None shall hinder me.
Oh my god, you burned so much mana now.
The true path.
Mana no longer pierce spell immunity. Previously only partially did. Okay, so you cannot cancel TPs anymore or what? Talent change. 10 strengths to 13? What, there is no, what are you talking about?
I.
Level 10 talent increase from 10 strengths to... It's 400 cast range attack speed. Wait, what is... Battle Hunger DPS. What? 120 Battle Hunger DPS. Oh no no. Wait, what's happening here?
Magic be dashed.
It I works go. As well. Sure, that'll be fixed. Mana Void Scepter duration increase from 70 to 100. Yeah. Restart.
No.
The Age of Ice.
That's not how I selected.
All magic flies before me.
Okay, it's bugging. Anti. God damn it!
Prepare thyself. All magic flies before me.
Name 8.
Onward.
Triddle fix that. Tempest double duration increased again by 2 seconds. Oh my god. Spark wave damage nerfed. Okay, it was pretty broken. It was broken. 2 more seconds. That's very good though. This here is probably very good now. Counter Helix cooldown, cooldown improved. Okay, so it's better early. Counter healing chance reduced all early. Alright. Calling Blade now deals damage through spell immunity. Bane. Okay, they reworked. Now it's a passive. Your builds now place an feeble debuff on target, reducing their state resistance and magic resistance. Alright, that's pretty sweet. That's pretty sweet. You cast Brain Sap and then all spells on that person will be increased for your team. Enfeeble has been moved down to the third ability. Yes, Brain Sap now heals for as much damage as the target takes. Yeah! You can play this as a core now. Brain Sap changed from pure to magical, but does more damage. Yes. Now deals damage through spell immunity. 15 Enfeeble steals attack speed to spell amp. Attack speed reduction to 20 spell life. Alright. Oh my god! Jesus, calm down. Flame break speed. Alright, let's pull him out.
As thou will it.
Let's pull him out, bat.
Anti-made. My soul dies.
Okay, stay on, girl. You can feel it's a lot faster. Now say damage on impact. Okay. Damage per second reduced, however, to 20. Cooldown is better, AoE increased by a lot. Knockback duration, so it's a longer stun. Frame rate knock distance is now fixed 300 units. Firefly no longer provides flying vision. Oh no no.
Flames that is bad.
But you get more movement speed. 20 movement speed now, which you never had before, and it gives you vision. I forgot what his vision is. Where is vision? 1218 is lower than everyone else. So with this one, you'll have extra long day vision, which is very good. You'll see them before they see you. And very good in night as well. Very good in night. But you, with the compensations, you can no longer have flying vision. Which is sad, but not the end of the world, I guess. But these compensations is very nice. Flame break is also no longer completely useless, I guess. Seems pretty bad still, though. Sticky Man no longer has a cast point. No longer requires turning to cast. Pog! Sticking him on the slope is like reduce. It's slightly worse.
Yeah, girl!
But you can do this. Oh, nice. That is nice. So many times you're being chased. You have to turn and cast.
My soul's on fire! Swoop in!
Oil him up.
Hell yeah! We ride!
First blood! Cut!
Flaming Lasso now uses damage to spell immunity.
Right off the bat!
Pog. I guess that's just for Ags. Talents buff, flame break, duration to 3 seconds. To compensate for it being worse damage over time. Still trash over 300 health. Move speed nerf. Okay, well the cooldown reduction is
Shadow of the Bat.
Be better. And flame break, cooldown. What? A nerf again? It seems pretty good though. This is super good, sticky napalm.
Peel it out.
It's very nice. Wild Axe is now pierces spell immunity. Seeing as he was on a 6 level, you think it's a super buff for Lone Druid? Yes, it's actually pretty good for Lone Druid because he can put all items from the creeps. Pierce spell immunity, probably one of these damage to spell immunity. Yes, small, nothing, no one cares. Rupture duration reduced early. Scale slightly better.
Hey Bulldog. Seems like this patch finally lets you be able to play on a competitive level again. See you at 2.
I could if I wanted 3. To, but I don't know if I want to. What does it mean? Out incoming. Wait, so if you use it on yourself, you do more damage now.
I have many friends.
You don't take so much.
Many, many friends.
Alright. Do 30% damage. Alright, alright. Strike bonus, moon speed increased. A little bit more. Oh! Cinderbrew now extends. Why is it so hot? Cinderbrew now extends range by 3 seconds rather than refreshing. Cinderbrew no longer deals the total damage. Yes. What the hell is Cinderbrew? I haven't seen this here in a million years. I forgot which ability it is.
The monster of another. I insist.
Okay, now deals the total damage of reach. Ignite total damage.
Yes.
Let's test this.
Things are on you.
I ignite you.
In a straight line.
I don't understand. Now ignites on any spell rather than on only damage above 80. Yes, rescale, that's more damage. Slow, rescaled. Cooldown way better. Mana cost increase. Goo reduces more armor. Glap. Retaliate return damage increased. No one cares. No one cares. Scepter reworked. Bro. Agility gain reduced. So like KS Bono reduces fake projection from nearby illusions. Nice. So you don't show like every other illusion hero, like PL and Naga. Rather if no longer slows, you know, reduces armor. Which is obviously very nice. And cooldown increased by 1. Chaos Orc Max here reduced. Oh, that's... What? That's a huge nerf. Your crit is way less. Granted, you reduced 5 armor. It's not really that good. 215 to 280. Phantasm outgoing damage rescaled. Less
this
early as well.
Drinking, so.
Incoming damage also increased. What is happening to this hero? But they have magic resistance now. Yes. Yes, that's the compensation. Is that enough? I mean, normally they just die to spells. That's the problem. But now they have more magic resistance. Very cool. Phantom illusions are not considered a strong illusion. It cannot be killed instantly with spells. Lion? Sabade? That seems fair, I guess. Rework separate. When you cast Phantom, because every allied hero to create an illusion, same stats as Phantom illusion, your hero gets an additional illusion as well. What the fuck?
I suppose. What's this?
What?
I waste.
Chaos rides. The horse of the apocalypse.
Okay, so you get one more illusion and they all get one illusion.
Emblem of Delarvex.
That seems pretty sweet. Oh, he's a range.
The horse of the apocalypse. Delarvex.
What is the range on this? Wait, is it global?
Delarvex.
It's global?
Meet in battle.
That seems pretty nice. You have to buy eggs though, but that seems very nice. Very nice. Overall, it seems nerfy though. You get minus armor, nice. Way less agility. Nice. Shen, holy precision, minimum health reduced. Okay, so in lane they're not as strong, level 1. Yeah, so you get it for free, I guess, from Roche. Holy precision, mana cost increased.
Your flying horse.
And our god, mana cost increased.
Quite impressive.
No more experience gain. Sebade. Ability rework. Base range reduce. Skeleton Walker now provides. I'm seeing the attack speed when coming out of invisibility. Last 4 seconds, so you don't have strafe anymore. But strafe with Death Pact. Consume an enemy unit. Skeleton. Consume an enemy unit. Skeleton. Or a level neutral. Gains 500 health. Because your attacks have minus 5 armor debuff. If your hero dies under your attack beat, last 3 seconds, you gain 5 damage permanently. And Death Pact Cooldown is refreshed. Burning Armor now deals 28% of your attack damage instead of your base damage. Oh! Run for health, strafe. Wait, does that mean you can get rapiers? What did it say? I didn't see.
Where goes my eye? Goes my... I alight to battle. Your life is mine.
Soldier's death.
Oh. Light my way.
Wait, does Daedalus work as well? Or how does that work? I guess not.
Yes, an arrow says what words cannot.
Killing spree.
You get a lot of damage now. Just get a lot of rapiers. And they do hyper damage.
Four innocent lives to wicked sick. Five innocents.
And then when you come out of this, you go to this, and you get great. Stop screaming. You don't need to project those anymore, though. You get death packed. This here is super squishy, but with this, you don't die. Fear dies under your attack debuff. You gain 5 damage permanently. And Death Pact cooldown is refresh. Very nice. Clockwork Scepter reworked. Nice. Because that Scepter was kind of shit. Cooldown is now 30, so you don't actually need it. Nice. Grants you overclocking. Refreshing all your abilities and granting a 40% bonus movement speed.
51 months sad
and percent and 200 attack speed. After it expires, you become stunned for 4 seconds. What?
This'll come your gears. Clockwork! Scepter!
New ability?
Prepare for battle!
Why did it not have Dota Dual Tip modified? It looks so bad.
Uh-huh.
Bonus movement speed 40.
It's 40%.
Wait, let me see here.
Man.
So now you would just do like this. And they don't stack.
In gear.
The 4 second stun is
armor power. Not yet.
All right, ability with base mana region increase from 0 to 1. Arcane ability rework. Arcane aura self mana region adjusted from to double on yourself. Arcane aura provides magic resistance and doubles on yourself. What? Crystal princess.
My armor.
Crystal maiden
is my coffin.
Okay, so you get 10% magic resistance. So how much worse is it? You get less mana. All levels. You get less mana, but you have the base one. And 10% magic resistance. And you get 20.
Indeed.
Very nice. Vacuum Rod works against the invulnerable sleeping targets. Oh, not. Now I got Darks here again.
Forward.
Is this
some assembly
required?
Or is it just.
No! The Darkling Seer.
Madeline, roll back the baby hand. Leukon, ja, Dobbeton. Who else is that? Who else makes him invulnerable? Sleeping? Elder Titan? Reworks have now reduces vacuum cooldown to 12. It doubles the width. Okay, the axe on this hero is pathetic, first of all. 12 second cooldown.
A grand design.
Build a wall. Hey, look at this. This is a small wall. Look at this wall.
As you will.
Actually, a good axe now.
Strategic. Deployment.
Since you're also a tanker, you're gonna get both multiple vacuums. Actually, good eggs. Shut up. Why do they do this? Isn't it just gonna be Naga Siren? Bedlam damage increased. Ooh, level 1 ult is way better now. And spell life steal, no one cares. Scepter reworked. Dazzle had the worst scepter of all heroes. Who the hell wants an AoE grave? It's so bad. Rework scepter. Shadow Wave bounces count target increased by 3. Bounce range by 200 and each bounce dispels the allied targets.
Ice Maiden.
Eat.
I cast a long shadow. Glow Wave.
9 targets. If you play with PL. Heal arc radius. What the hell is heal arc radius? Is that the balance range?
On my way. Zap. Dark light. Dazzle. Zap. Tremor on.
Dispels.
I have many friends.
It's not a hard
many,
spell,
many
I guess.
Friends.
Cool. Base int increased by 3. Alliance limp. 3 more damage. That's huge. Thunderstrike now applies a 0.1 second slow. Okay. And health increased. Doom scepter reworked. Yes, it was very uninspiring, honestly. Base damage increased by 3. Devour max level creep. You can take a level 4 now, Azard. Nice. Devour cooldown rescaled. 7 in all levels. Gold increased a lot though, because of this. So you get overall more gold now. The more desideration now matches cooldown. Scorf Earth, 16 on levels, better in lane now. The value point of Scorf Earth is insane now. One level in it always, Infernal Blade, base damage. 25, way weaker in lane. Front Blade stun duration increased from, to 1.75 seconds and plus 2 DPS duration. Applies break. Oh my god. That is so much better.
There falls my foe.
That is so much better.
Shadows. Damnation like me. My scepter at last. Bring
god.
It. Hell's on earth.
Burn duration 6 seconds. It's so much damage as well.
The fire spreads.
And it breaks. Oh my god, that's so good. Now that is a good axe. Elder Dragon formula is nothing else. Surprise. Flying Pathing! And 210 GPM to cooldown reduction. Oh, no more GPM bullshit.
Midnight of your soul.
Oh, you're actual dragon now. Not only do you become black, but you become a dragon that can fly. That is quite an upgrade. People are already pretty good eggs that no one buys.
Who calls the dragon?
We fly over trees. Corner reduction. This hero has insane level 30 talents. All his talents are so good. Oh my god, if you get 30 on this hero.
Cuts no more.
Ability rework. Agility. Reduced by 10. Base damage reduced though. Or got buffed. That's a gilly. Frost arrows now deal damage. Frost arrows no longer last 7 seconds on creeps. Gust knockback increased. Replace pushing arrow with multi-shot. Wow. Death Medusa is here.
My quiver and bow are ready. Good enough.
Oh, it's literally tiny eggs. Oh my god, that's very long.
So be it.
Channels for 175 seconds. During that time, it releases a flurry of arrows. It releases 12 arrows over 3 waves. Arrows deal of your base damage, a lot of your base damage. Apply frost arrows slow. Travel distance is twice your attack range. Oh.
Agreed.
That's a cooldown. That is a pretty good ability.
Forward.
That is a pretty good ability. Mark machine no longer instantly creeps. Proc damage is now 60 bonus. Now also provides bonus agility to you and nearby heroes. Equal to 35 of your agility.
My bow is drawn.
Okay. Well, this here is very different. Multi-shot damage.
Mega kill! Double kill!
Maybe let me get my arrows back. And then you can die.
What does the even proc do? Ignoring their base armor. Alright, so this gets bonus agility? How much? Wait, is it only range heroes or what?
Yes. Very well.
I'm not getting any. Oh, no, it is. What? Wow, 44 agility. Not bad. Alright, well, this here is completely different now. 2 more ints. Rolling distance. 40 damage to 50. Oh, 1 more armor, alright. Sean told himself their lead duration increased from 0 to 1, so it takes longer to jump. It will not be interrupted. You're stunned or rooted. Now provides 75 attack range. Echo slam base damage increased.
The dragon waits.
Go in silence. I see death.
Earth Shaker.
Because they have way more time to react now. 0.25 seconds more to react. Alright. Earth Splitter now deals damage through spell immunity. Earth Scepter Mirror now grants you spell immunity when Esmus returns to you based on the number of heroes hit. Yes. Yes. So if you hit four heroes, you get 8 second BKB. Glamp. Ember Spirit, Observation, fuck this hero, slit of his hero damage, buff. Oh, a nerf. Okay. Chantra's Axe is terrible. Impetus is now basic ability, is 20% damage, and let me just test it. Chantra's.
Let the battle begin.
Stop.
I spring. Shaking.
Basic ability.
Spoink.
He's no longer casting lane then because you don't have the slow anymore.
Yeah. Ah, scepter.
Really?
Open it.
Three-second cooldown.
Attack.
Oh shit, I'm sorry.
Spring.
Unstoppable!
No longer for his spell immunity. Shant cooldown, okay, 29 levels. Cooldown in level, yes. Enchant can now only control one unit. Duration increase. Enchant can no longer target an already enchanted unit. Enchant decrease now gets more health, more damage, and fully heals it. Untouchable is now an ultimate ability.
You black.
Untouchable now pierces spell immunity.
Here I come.
Pierces spell immunity? Oh, that's pretty poggers. Life stealers.
Skip ahead. Foraging.
So now you're not just hard can but BKB anymore. That's nice. Now it feels like an ultimate. Receptor has been reworked. Can you sproink? Yep. Interesting.
Mm-hmm.
Interesting. But how will you have mana to use heal? You need to use heal in lane because you will take damage. Well, good news, she's no longer a cancer hero. Galap. Midnight Pulse damage change from pure to magical, and it does no more damage. And then Eidolon attack range. Oh.
Light of foot, light of heart. No!
What's this spell? Oh, that's actually very nice. Time lock duration nerfed. Chronosphere increased by 20 again. That's 40 over 2 patches. Shut up!
As you wish.
Talent nerf. That everyone went from 500 less there. Time lock now deals damage to spell immunity. Oh, that is a pretty big buff, man. Scepter has been worked now, place time lock proc on enemy on units at the destination of time walk within 250 AOE. That's not pure spell immunity. Oh my god, you jump in, you get time lock. That's so good if you get a free axe on this hero. Oops, void.
I have seen how this war ends. Ah, scepter.
Oh my god, it's so good.
Yes.
That is so good.
Face forward.
But his ultimate is super long now, man. Holy shit. You can even do it on your team fight, you can just use it on the ground. You probably don't buy Axe, but if you get it from Roshan, it's insanely good. Reworked our time delay worked mechanically. Cause spells to progress to cooldown more slowly while under this effect.
The March of Time.
What does that mean?
Time flows. I'm here. foreseen is forearmed. I'm not ready.
Okay, is she baiting you with the time?
I go.
Yes, I get Londru, guys. Stop spamming about it. I'm gonna start banning you. The meme is getting tiresome. Phantom embrace Ren damage increased. Okay. Ink Swell cast range buffed. Okay. Scepter upper is the furthest unit away in its range. Scepter range increased. Is that good? Okay, Burning Spear now costs 4% of current health instead of fixed 5. 4% of current health. Life Break. Slower. 1 second. Less Life Break now deals damage to spell immunity. Scepter has been rolled to Life Break now taunts the enemy. Pog? Alright, nothing to test. This is a taunt. Scepter reworked. Invoke cooldown reduced by 0.3 for each orb level. Invoke base cooldown increase of 6 to 7. Mogno like Ben from Scepter. Scepter now has Cataclysm to Sunstrike.
One, you're a Pog champ. Thanks for the laugh, sir. Have a good day.
Minus 10, that's a nerf. Cataclysm to minus 10, cool. Tornado to plus 2 Force Spirit armor reduction. What? That's a 25 talent. Interesting. Interesting. Base armor increased by 2. Tetana slows enemies. Overcharge cooldown reduced. Okay, overcharge now provides HP memory per second instead of damage reduction. Still provides attack speed. Modern units applied on both targets with tether, and thus tether targets units for more. Okay, so you can still burst them. 90 GPM to 5 health region to rise spell life, so it's terrible, slow, 120 GPM. So there's no spirit supply slow anymore, now you get it from tether. Alright, rip. This has always been broken though, well, I'm sure it'll still be played. Strength gain increased. No one cares. Movement speed by 25. The spell build? He's buffing my spell build. Binding Light, here we go. Binding Light mana cost increased a lot early. Fuck you. Binding Light cast range. Way worse early. Cast range reduced by 100. 250. That's it. Okay, that seems very underwhelming. X mark cooldown increased to 14 in max. That's a rough. Cooldown increased by 20 on all levels. And to 40% or a skeptic price the Torrent Storm ability. Pog.
Time is Kanka.
We're all in the same boat.
As you wish. A scepter to rule the rolling seas. I go.
Oh my god.
Fair enough.
When I grow wide, I want to be like you. Thanks for streaming. Fat.
That is so good. It doesn't do any damage. Yes, it does.
A new form.
Oh my god, that is so good. And this here is already playing as a utility, so you'll always buy this.
Growing in.
Set my jib.
We play league now, boys. Poke champ.
I have the torrent AoE, I guess, which is added by this.
By your compass.
So that seems pretty good. Overwhelming odds, okay. No one cares. Slashrak, more elf. Yes. Sinister Gaze, I'm ready for some lone druid, boys. Sinister Gaze now drains current mana back to you.
New content pog.
The target's current mana. Okay, current mana. Chain Frost damage increased by 25 per bounce. Pog. Guys, you can't pep a laugh. You realize Lone Druid has been massively buffed because all the neutral items, right? So before you pep a laugh, I'm sure you've not considered that. Scepter's Mirror Sinner's Gaze now has a 400 AoE target ability.
Your middle tower has fallen.
Is fallen. Sucked out with the tide.
Come to Papa! Nice.
Yes.
Come to Papa! That is very good. That is a good axe. And you can do it over vision as well. You don't even need to see them. Right? Can you hide somewhere, please?
A chill wind.
Come to Papa! Okay, you need vision of them, I guess. You do need vision of them. Protects by movement slow to Shane Frost unlimited bounces. Ability to work receptive strength gain reduced by a lot. Base attack better. Base attack attacks faster. Base damage reduced. Base armor increased. I like always the changes. Rage no longer increases attack speed. Rage provides 50 movement speed. What?
My ship has come in.
No! A thief in the fight. For the master.
I guess movement's been set, alright. Alright. Movement of life reduced from 50 to 35. Feast now presses provides attack speed. Feast no longer deals damage based on target's max health. Feast now provides 3% lifesteal on target's max health. Infest now automatically take control of a target when it's allowed.
I steal a headline by joining.
What? Infest now automatically take control over a target when it's allowed. Infested heroes have a 50% movement speed and creeps have 25. Infested units also gain health and heals for that amount. I cannot leave him. Infest now heals for 5% of max health per second while you're in another unit instead of a burst heal on exit. Rogue Scepter. Scepter reduces Infest going to 20 and increases the cast range to 600. Causes the Infest target. You get the rage buff. That's as long as rage does. Attack speed. Oh, they buffed it from 1 to 1.5. A 50% buff. Still terrible. Or maybe it's, I mean, it's a bit different now, so I don't know. Yes, cast range nerf. Strength gain, lion. Mana drain slow. Lone druid, ability rework. Spirit Bear attack range increased. Spirit Bear changed from basic to hero. Pog. That means they take way less damage. Spirit Bear damage from basic to hero does way more damage. No longer has defender.
How's that been watching you read patch notes? Spirit Bear
no longer has defender. What was defender again? Oh, so you take less damage, right? And Demolition level 1, Return level 1, Entangle level 1, Poggies, Entangle, increases as you level it, now 3 second channeling ability, cooldown 30, weird champ, this is a weird champ, Demolish is now 10-20s, Spirit Bear damage reduced from 30, 30? Spirit Bear now levels up when your hero does and gains plus 5 damage. Poggies, Spirit Bear health reduced Are you a champ? Spirit Bomb gains health on your hero. So when you're level 10 or 11, there's 750 more health. Wow! It's claws from physical to magical. Oh my god, there's so much. Spirit Link is now passive. Spirit Link no longer heals Spirit Bomb when no longer does damage. Spirit Link. increase your attacks for causing the damage dealt by Spirit Bear to heal under. Oh my god. That's so nice. Look at this, he does damage to me. But then in lane, I just get healed. Actually broken now. The hair's broken. Spirit Link attack speed reduced, but overall better for sure. True form 100 cooldown. An actual ultimate. Oh, look at level 30.
Colon.
Look at his damage. Look at his damage on life. A stop shield work on bear. There is no stop shield. You cannot buy it.
A measured piece.
But because it's divine armor type now, it should take less damage in lane. Transform into melee, bro. Let's just try it. Come on, man. And I get all the abilities as well. Hog. Oh my god, you're gonna be so squishy without the ult, bro. Look at my elf! Look! Where's Battlecry? Transform into Big Game, heal on cast as well. 20 armor against your Spirit Bear Entanglers. Against your Spirit Bear Entangler, it sets your melee attack range to 250, duration 40. Wow! 7 armor cast on both your hero and Spirit Bear cast on either. Oh! Wow, that is a very nice buff. That is very nice.
Yes.
Sever Shore AoE increased. Battle Cry to True Form cooldown. No one cares. Okay, to True Form health.
Done.
You know how broken this hero is now, right? This hero is completely broken now. Because of the new items, you can have all the items on the hero. This hero is all broken now. Time to get rank 1 before they nerf it, boys. Luna ability rework. Base strength increase, base damage increase. Whoa, that's a nice increasement. Moonglaive now works with critical strikes. Luna blessing rework. Now provides allied units 25 attack damage and total armor bonus. Under is broken as hell, I guess.
How are you getting thrown out of Sweden so you don't have to go to Tia this year?
Let's go.
Oh, maybe I need to do the skeletons.
Let's go. What do you see?
A monster kill!
Because if your initial crits, it does more damage than all. That's nice. Scepter rework, bruh! Reworked Howl. Now cause all enemies within 2000 AoE to have reduced armor and deal less base damage. Last 8 seconds. Okay, that's actually really nice. Against Terrorblade reduces base damage by 40? That seems very nice. Howl is now cast around your wolves as well. Oh, Reason Scepter. Grants Wolf Bite. Targets an allied hero to convert them and provide shapeshift properties, including melee. Grants both of you 30% lifesteal and shared 30% lifesteal to heal it, to heal the other when 1200 range with each other. Bruh, come on, man.
From exile, I am.
Yes.
Lycan. Ah,
scepter.
I might need to have my spells first.
I look to battle.
It's a super pig.
Guilty to none.
Magnus Scepter reworked. Shockwave pull distance increased. Let's test him out. Magnus.
The dark moon comes.
I thought you'd team
up. More. Empower cleave damage reduced. Please tell me it's gonna make it passive. Oh. Cleave damage reduced by a lot. And damage reduced also a lot. Empower duration increased. Empower enough device double effect on when cast on yourself.
They cannot
hog. So 90 instead of 74 and 50 instead of 40. Reverse polarity now deals damage to spell immunity. Okay, it's like no damage, so is it? 50 to 200. Reward scepter now reduces security cooldown to 4 seconds. Cast by half and removes mana cost.
By the gleam of my horn.
Oh my god.
Scepter is no horn, but I price it nonetheless.
People always lull the blink, but it's super hard to blink and secure someone, but now it's instant. Now it's instant. Okay, that is very good. That's very good, Axe. If you get it for free, that is. Would you ever buy this Axe? 4 second cooldown. That seems insane. Ability to work. God's Rebuke now. Knockback now has 40% slow. That's pretty sweet.
I love to
Why am I playing this here? This here is so good.
My spear. Beg for mercy.
Now slows. Bulwark can be toggled on, putting a weapon away.
I choose okay. this path myself. I hunt. As the thickest flies.
So if you're backing off, you just do this
a
now.
Step towards victory.
Oh no, I'm being chased. I'm being chased, guys.
Da, 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 da. No doubt.
Actually, cool. Wait, so it's still on? Because your movement speed will be 20% slower while in this mode, and 70% of attack progress will be redirected towards you instead of your allies. Only attacks affects attack progress that are within your shield block angle. And a button now destroys trees inside the arena.
My feet know the way.
What?
March! All in stride.
I got you. Hold. Hold.
Da, 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 da. What a team.
This ability is fucking awesome now. This is fucking massive buffs, man. Look at this guy. What if you go to movement speed build?
Sanj and Yasha. We go! Huzzah! I never let go of my shield. You're welcome!
Oh, this is a massive buff, man. Slow added. Bulwarks, you can toggle it on to protect your team and dodge when you're backing. Before you had to man up or get killed while turning your back, but now you just moonwalk.
To the front!
Very big buffs to this hero. How does it work against sniper ult? Yes. Is it only attacks? It's only attacks. Or what did I say? Attack projectiles. Attack. Intelligence increased. She's smart. Mystic Snake now applies 30% movement slow. And if it's a turn rate slow for 3 seconds, Mystic Snake no longer steals mana from the enemies, but still provides it to you. She's no longer cancer, but she slows you now. Stone Gaze duration reduced. Stone Gaze damage amplification reduced. Stone Gaze now provides you a 20% movement speed increase. And range increased. And then some of the slight talent tweaks. Fuck this hero, secondary mana max stun duration scale so early. It's way weaker now. Way weaker. No disco time now, I'm sorry, but thank you. I'll play it later. Tree dance cooldown reduced. Oh. Nice. Ambition increased. Morphling. Morph no longer has 2 different health and mana amounts. The percentage of health and mana is maintained between both forms, thank god. Morph now provides the scepter 15 markers as a base feature. Agility, nerf, and ensnare. Ooh, very nice. Fuck Cornaga. Exterminator is spot. Here we go, boys. Bum.
Hold your pep.
Oh my god. Intelligence gain increased. Agility. 4 more agility. I was not really expecting a big loan her profit buff. Actually, pretty nice. His right clicking is way better now. Half armor better, more in lane. Very nice. Scepter, Horsehopper aura range increased. Pog. Reduce sub damage increased. Pog. No longer pierces spell immunity. Oh. Okay, so it was not broken, I thought. Scepter has been reworked. Now it reduces Ghost Shroud cooldown to 10 seconds. Because Horsehopper aura to deal 2x as much damage while Ghost Shroud is active. Wow.
To those behind,
stand aside.
Necrophos.
So always level to max, and you see like, oh, this hurts quite a lot. 7 down. I do this. Look at the damage to take all of them. They're all melting. Cooldown. I don't have eggs yet. Oops. There we go.
Forward.
But I have the talent though.
Plague spreader. Vector of infection.
Okay.
Holy shit! Holy shit! I'll track you.
Nice.
You
very nice.
For the flesh flies.
This doesn't go through BKB, and once you can stun, it's a little bit dancing, but whatever. I use it as a stun a lot. 70 attacks between your heart support region reduction. Oh, 194, and outside of it, 260. The region is reduced. Very interesting. 24, and then when it's outside, 33. I have to give up magic resistance though. It's alright. And then they nerfed heart support, alright. Voice up no longer reduces cooldown. Voice up stun duration nerfed. Talent 35. All right. Very shocked how little they nerfed these heroes, but they do buff them. Nice. 10 more movement speed. That is a lot. That is very long. Base strength reduced by 2. Ignite hitting an already affected unit now adds it to the duration and then just refreshing it. Pog? No one's gonna pick this ever. Nice fuck. No one is ever gonna pick this. Scepter reworked. One of the worst ags. Base mana increased. 4% cast range increased by 800. AoE by 115 causes half of the root duration to be stunned. Oh my god.
To those behind.
Yes, so the longer you channel.
Antiseptic, that is what shock. One fortune coming up.
Oh! And look at the range. Look at his range.
Once again and again.
Oh, you want to TP out? Good luck. Entura.
Entura.
Hmm. Way better than last axe, at least. Oh, the ability, your base attack increased. So he attacks slower. Arcane Orb rescale, Arcane Orb no longer splash them, no longer steals int, replace equilibrium with essence flux. Fuck this hero. Oh god, I hate this hero so much.
The Oracle. This
power of fair warning.
Essence flux. Passive against you, 25 chance to restore 50% of max mana when you cast an ability. Can be activated for 6 seconds and cause all damage you deal to slow enemy movement speed.
Path of destruction.
Yes. Holy shit!
Mana increased. I can heal off itself.
Last warning.
Okay, so you will not get mana outside of this.
Not
you
yet.
Need to use 25 second cooldown. Holy shit! Zero finally got our mana now. Let's hope that this now is broken. Now, Sun Eclipse no longer deals damage based on intelligence difference. Sun Eclipse no longer drains mana. Nice! Now, the base damage. Nice. Now deals 0.86x difference between you and the enemy's max mana.
In flight.
Oh my god, the maths just got very complicated.
Ill omens.
Okay, so you have 1,000 mana. 1,000 damage.
I'm not ready. Darkness
what if
advances.
I have a lot of Octarian cores? It gives me mana.
I bring
your
sanity.
Fuck this hero, man.
Yes. Foul portents.
Nothing wrong here. Sun Eclipse now provides buff charges that increase your max mana of a charge. You get one charge per arcane hit orb. Fuck this, I don't want to read this. It makes me puke. Range increased by 100. Rolling Thunder duration plus 4. Blur plus 5 because no one picks it. Reworked Scepter. Phantom Rush agility bonus. Duration reduced from 2 to 1.5. What?
What? Dark, oblique, and obsolete.
I need some patience.
Attack!
Removes cooldown and minimum distance.
Now! Swarm!
It doesn't work or what? It's still a cooldown.
Holy shit!
Stop attacking!
Forward!
You mean I have the consumable axe? No, I don't.
Axe run!
We march! Into battle!
What?
Quickly! As ordered!
Yes. They cannot hide from us.
Yes.
We agree. Simple. We hunt. We will find
you. I don't understand. I only get a gilly sometimes.
We understand.
Enemies need killing.
I don't understand. Rush speed boost is not always available when attacking enemy units, regardless of the cooldown. The gilly bonus is still cooldown limited. Okay. Very cool. Base strength increased by 2. Glap. Supernova does MSG spell immunity. Glap. Pretty nice buff, honestly. Fix a bug because orders not register sometimes. Oh, the leaded thing. Waning Rift now has 350 cast range. Moves you to location and silences there. Oh. Puck is a pog. Your Puck is a well-designed hero. That's fun to watch.
In your tongue, I am silenced.
Oh my god, it's so much better. Oh my god.
Silence.
Oh my god, what a buff.
Silence.
You can just do so many things now. And there's no nerf for it. Dreamcon now deals an initial damage? What the fuck?
Commendable notion.
Phase shift attacks.
Bye-bye. Exactly so. They shall regret this.
So without the cast range, it's like this. It's still very nice, honestly. This is fucking very big. Now deals damage, except now deals damage with spell immunity. As a result of spell immunity, yes. 10 challenges, 60 stats. To face immediately launches one attack on phase shift cast. Where's my music? Fucking YouTube pausing the music because you have to buy premium, whatever. Then with the item, the new items. Where is it? Where is the tier 5 items? What was the 5500 range? Seer stone.
Very well.
Item, seer.
Silence.
Oh, you get a free dagger, guys.
Silence.
You got this item.
Absolutely.
Oh my god. Then you have, what's the other one? Fallen Sky. Item, fallen. Do you have these items on this hero?
I venture.
How do you kill him? You blink here, then you blink here, then you go here, then you can go here.
Here I am. Silence.
Okay, there are cooldowns though. But if you're playing on free and cheating, you can do it. Very nice. Fuck. That's some big buffs on this hero. Very nice. But he just deals initial damage? You just added 100 damage? Very nice. Punch, first you reduce. Rot, self damage is no longer lethal. Dismember now deals damage through spell immunity. Rework Scepter reduces Dismember cooldown to 11, allows you to target an ally with Dismember, instantly swallowing them into your belly and healing them for 4% of their max health per second. The ally can exit whenever they want by issuing a command. Talents, you can reduce Meat Hook if you want. Dismember duration to Dismember double damage heal.
I have many friends. Many, many friends.
Huh? Oh, boy! Fresh meat!
Prepare for battle. Yeah.
Pretty medium nerf, huge nerf. Nice. I mean, this is a nerf to this hero. This hero got nerfed. Another one up as a base 50 damage spells that trigger it. Oh, hold up.
Good
hold
idea.
Up. If there's one thing you always see with this hero, is this here against Witch Doctor.
Cut off him.
I channel the power.
If that works as it should. Witch Doctor. This one here.
By the nether reaches.
A little jaunt.
Okay, it doesn't do it anymore. Now only parks against things that affect magic stick. Okay, maybe we should have read this first. Netherworld scaling value reduces from... Alright. Seems okay, I guess. I don't know how much how good that is. Guilty gain increased. Better right clicker. Scream of pain increased by 10%. Glap. Replace unstoppable current with Storm Surge. Passive armor provides 10 movement speed to nearby allies. Has double values on your hero. I have Storm that passively shocks every unit in 500 range around you every 3 seconds. Still has an active component.
By the nether reaches.
Razor.
I return.
Razor. Very well.
Which one is whipping? Is it this thing?
Quick as lightning.
Yes.
Okay. Studying that causes race to continue to attack the linked target. You cannot attack the other targets during this time. You cannot really suck illusions that well, I guess.
Hello, Mr. Bulldog, your number one fan from Peru. What hero do you think is going to be meta? I want to get out of Ark and love your quality content, no crapper.
Your attacks now happen automatically while you're moving with interruptions. So long as it's legal attacks.
On my round!
This will come as a shock!
Oh my god.
Forward!
Okay, let's see.
Blood.
Seems like just buffs. All around?
First blood.
I guess he,
and the atmosphere's electric.
Can't farm the fast before 6. This seems like buff. Static link duration, weaker in lane, but still good enough. Wait, does this here just get giga buffed? Fix out the storm targeting ethereal units when you cannot hurt them. Static link, 12 strength. Okay, it seems very good.
As you wish.
It's very good. Riki, agility, okay, 12 less agility. Way less agility gain. Strength increase, you don't die like a bitch. Base damage increased by 8 overall. The music stop again. Base armor increased by 2, one more region, base movement speed increased by 25, smells no longer slows, no longer reduces vision, miss rescaled, there's more screen radius, smoke screen cooler increase, Blink Sorgan has 2 charges, Blink Sorgan damage, Blinker Diagnosis is ultimate, has 432 fade delay, not able to handle backstab damage. What? Tricks of trade is not basic, but takes 4 times over 2 seconds.
I channel the power.
I bring the spark of...
I've lost
my dream is Deathcraft.
taken to booty ass snicker. Kep.
I go in silence.
Let me just permaban him. Slash. All right, there we go.
Since you put it like that.
Free ult?
Whom shall I kill? As you bid.
Increases duration. Attacks. Castrating allows you to target an ally hero hiding inside of them.
Yes.
Okay. Alright, base armor increased by 1. I should have done it 60. Fade Bolt Hero Attack 75.
How are Aki and EGM doing?
Nice. Good, I guess. 10 more attack speed. Normally, person that deals damage to spell immunity. Okay, recommend Soul's final radius reduced. No longer reduces attack damage. Now causes units to run away from Shadow Fiend. Points per wave impacted. Does not happen on death. MVP. Thank you. Making them run away. Ward slightly buffed. 5-10. Whatever. Plus 40. Agility gain reduced a lot. Attack priority speed reduced. Okay. Glaze of Wisdom up temporarily steals 2-3 int for 40 seconds. Glaze of Wisdom damage reduced a little bit to compensate. Last for damage reduced by a lot. Now deals damage based on 3x the difference between your intelligence and theirs. I don't want to do maps. Last word becomes 600 AoE spell. Okay, so I want the silences then. Ancient
OS
seal.
Frog clap OS, frog clap OS, frog clap.
Yeah, strange buffed. That says silence. And cooldown nerve buff. Crash AoE increased by 10%. Set the reward. Now pounce now has 2 charges and travels double the distance speed. Lars,
how the hell did you see? You made no wolf of me. Yeah.
Oh, shit.
Well, hello, Pudge.
2 charges. You want to catch me?
Wait. Over
oh,
here.
If you double tap, you lose it. You gotta be careful with that.
Right.
What is the cooldown? Oh my god, this is so bonkers. Oh my god, this is so good.
Right.
But again, it's good if you get free right axe from Roche. I don't think you buy it.
Right.
Yeah, the stats are pretty nice though, but no. I don't know if you buy that. In a serious game, that is. Spurs now deals damage to Spadic. Okay. Shrapnel damage increased by 5. Rework Scepter. Reduce cast time of session 8. From 2 to 1 and cost you to disable target for 1.8 seconds. Fix this doesn't increase spell immunity if you gain magic immunity while in there. Shrapnel damage. That's so nice.
Cloaked and daggered. Throw me back!
So 20 you pick shrapnel DPS now. Friend. It's very good. 110 damage per second.
Scepter! Mark for death!
Uh-huh. 1.8 second stun, that's pretty good.
Yes!
Just Pretty good. Greater Bash not deal damage through magic. Never saying that this is magic. Talent not deals damage through magic as results. Okay. Reward Warcard. Cost ally heroes within 7 range to get 15 armor and 24 damage. Additionally, increase your own moon speed by 18%. Okay. Rose Scepter. Stormhammer gains 500 cast range and you travel along it. You can no longer get kited with late game Sven. Late game Sven is back. This is very simple. You blink in and you kill the enemy and win the team fight, or you lose it and get kited. Now with Axe, you can fight forever. Actually good.
One night at the service. Good idea.
The range is also super long.
That's right.
And then now you have to pick Stormhammer cooldown with this. The lifesteal is not even that good already. I mean, look at this. 7 second cooldown now. You. Is this based on my movement speed or what?
Yeah.
No, it's based on the Stormhammer. Stop baiting me. Proximity minus 3 charges with 50% replenish time. Fuck this hero. Scepter now also because your mind's cast range should be increased by 400. Wait, let me just, is that just your ult, Dummies, or what?
Hey, how you doing?
Yeah, just, wait, no, it's not just your axe.
Fun!
Side by the width increased. Precision cyanide production cooldown reduced. Oh, this is Ags. The one was so trash. From 30 to 15, a half. Reflection is now an AoE target ability. Has 700 cast range and 470 AoE. Current damage incoming damage reduced by 40. Kraken shell damage. 5, 10, 20, 40. Stacks with passive base damage. Oh. Agility growth. They buffed him. Cannot. Like, this here's so cheesy, man. Base strength increased from 17 to 18. Base mana region increased. Puke. 20 movement speed. 15 less damage. Pepper left. Tree grab no longer has charges. Tree grab now causes you to move 25 speed slower. Tree grab now bonus damage no longer works under nice. Tree grab building damage reduced. Base moon speed increased by 10. Living armor is pretty. Now has a 700 cast range spell. Always lasts 8 seconds. Provides 16 armor and restores 250 health over duration. Cast point reduced. Cooldown increased. What? Isn't that worse?
Time is set.
Down we go.
Thoughts cross my mind as the sun crosses the sky, I suppose.
My doom.
Come here. I'll protect you.
Okay. Okay, that seems not nice. Leisha has been reworked. Now it's a self-cast spell. Drains life from a random enemy within 700 range.
I'll not be rushed. Life and death. Yes, yes. I suppose. Yes!
Okay. Nature grass has been replaced with nature's grasp. Target the location, creating vines along the way.
Yes, yes.
Ice path.
Dominating.
Oh, this is a different hero now.
Is this now go to three?
Oh, it actually does damage with the ult now as well. This is completely new now.
Mega kill! Triple kill!
Deals half damage to creeps, one lasts up to 12 seconds, cast range. If any vine touches a tree, all the vines have a better effect!
How about us? I'm under attack!
Wait, so now it's at 26 now, damage.
Unstoppable!
Now it does 17.
You holy shit! Rampage! Holy shit!
Can't say it looks good though. It looks really bad, I have to say. It does not look pretty.
Such impatience.
It looks like a placeholder. Mine's not on enemy heroes. So if you have 50% better fate, still by 60%.
Trees are not so good with motion, you know.
Right, so let's test this twice. So you get hit by this. The slow is still the same, even though it says. Mine's still feeling more damage, alright. Overgrowth duration nerfed early, but now deals damage as part of the base skill instead of scepter priority. Overgrowth now deals damage to spell immunity. 60 more heal, nature's grasp DPS. Beep, bop, blah, blah, blah. All right, troll, new hero, more agility gain. Preservation surge and snare chance increased by 2%. Dusk, 5 more movement speed, more region, Warwick now deals damage for spell immunity, more health, and ice shard, cool. Agility gain increased, base armor increased, rescaled, nerfed, okay. Base armor reduced by 1, solar mana cost increased in laning stage, you can just spam heal your friend, some occlusion size reduced, flesh golem has been reworked, now increase your strength by 30, 40, 50. Percent your attacks, slow the enemy by 40% and deal 35 DPS 5 seconds. Zombies do double damage to your unit under the effect of the attack debuff. Zombies should do a quad damage. Like double damage is like nothing still. Let's test it.
Let's light the fuse.
Oh, very well.
My tomb is thundered.
Okay, let's level up a little bit. Okay, so it doesn't do anything right now, it just gives me more strength. I hit you once, bam. It slows you and you take AoE damage. Not a lot. It's not a lot. I take the zombies. Okay, we do a little bit more. Especially with this, maybe. You're eating him!
Holy shit! Which one? Holy shit! Double kill!
Well, the health gain again is way less. Definitely nerf ult. Boom speed reduced by 10. Nerfing now causes you to jump forward. And cooldown increase because of that.
I defend what is mine. For the forest. Seek the foe.
This game is so dead. Why do you think that? Oh no, set the rework. Wave of Terror, Vision, Duration Increased, Vengeance Aura. Has been reworked and provides some of the attack range and attributes to player units. Attack range? Hoggies? That seems kind of good. Vengeance Aura illusion is now considered a strong illusion, cannot be instantly killed. Nice. Nether Swap now works against invulnerable sleeping targets. Scepter reworked. Nether Swap now fears enemies when you land in an area of 700 for 2 seconds.
I only go
my name
to sleep.
Is vengeance. Scepter, let my vengeance soar.
Work with range, melees. Come on, what's a melee hero? Terror Blade.
No,
it does not. Okay. Venomous poison thing now reduces regeneration by 30%! Poggies! Poison have no longer spirit spell immunity. Because if they're BKB. Oh, you can still put it on them if they're BKB. Wait, did damage? What is it? Poison have no longer spirit spell immunity. Are you telling me it did damage before? Reduced regen, that's very good. Very good. Base attack speed increased by 20. Poison attack range increased. Poison attack has been rewarded. Reduced magic resistance by 9%, movement speed by 12, and now deals 16 DPS. The debuff can now be incremented by up to 5 times. Each effect in duration, not independent debuffs, so lasts for 4 seconds. Wait, he's back to being a lane dominator?
Prepared, but poisoned. I fly into a rage.
Back to being a lane dominator.
Forward.
However, that toxin cooldown increased. Nanotoxin no longer reduces magic resistance. Nanotoxin now deals damage, increasing amount of damage when it continues in the area.
I fly.
Okay, so the longer you're in, like Static Storm? It seems like, how do you farm with this here? I guess you can still farm, it's just slower. My percent goes to damage. Poison stack. Okay. Okay, okay. 90 damage at 20 now. Stone form helper, build on your hero, now targets an area, causing the close. What?
I
am the god who you shall hunt. Indeed.
That is pretty nice. That is pretty nice. Warlock experience reduced to 10, 15. Spell immunity to 100% magic resistance. Okay. Okay, that's kind of big nerf because they were pretty pepeg late game. In some games, the country no longer has haste. So you now remove speed limit because you need to be on slow, I guess you 225 movement speed. Wait. Oh, so you can go past the movement speed billet. What, so you can go boots now?
I spread, I enter the pattern.
Slightly yes. Worse level 1, however, when you go like this,
yes.
You go treads. You get 30 more movement speed.
Skitter.
And then maybe you go Yasha. And then you get the max one.
Hey, Loom.
Now you go boost on this hero. Focus fire attack speed increased by 25. From grants invisibility to minus. Okay, this is fair. The invisibility of 20 was fucking broken.
Yes! Scatterling in.
That's pretty good.
Yes.
That's pretty good.
Bitter pattern.
You cannot be slowed. Winter Curse no longer reduces damage on the target from the Winter Wyvern player's hero units. Winter Curse no longer reduces damage on the targets from Winter Wyvern player hero units. I don't understand. Oh, so you can still hit. You can still hit with Winter Wyvern. Winter Wyvern can do damage, and if he has Necro, he can also do damage.
Can you see Cruciatus, Slark, Pounds, and Disruption Field now?
I don't know. If you go fast enough, then yes, I'm not keen enough to find out or test it. Mortal Strike, Skeleton Damage reduced by 5. No longer affects creep, still affects your skeletons. Temporary life still reduced. Okay. Now provides damage. Half values for skeletons. Nimbus mana cost increased by 50 and nerfed by 10. We did it! We did it! Remember to click the subscription button, but that's not good enough. You gotta click the bell. Click the bell. You gotta also click the bell and thumbs up.